Python class 8, Python control flow, loop statements. Yesterday, we discussed the Python control flow. Conditional statements are, you could say, decision making statements. Today, Python control flow, part 2, loop statements. See, before going to discuss loop statements, one example is there for yesterday's topic. Yesterday we discussed nearly 6 types of usage of conditional statements, Sandhya. 6 types of usage. Can you remember? Can you tell me 6 types of usage we discussed for conditional statements of Python language? One is run or execute a block of statements when condition is true. Continue.
Condition is true and when
second one,
if statements
run a block of statements when condition is true, otherwise execute another block of statements else part. Two way condition.
Yes, sir.
Next, third one, execute a block of statements
when a
condition is true. Next, yes. Fourth one, execute a block of statements when a compound condition is true, otherwise execute another block of statements. Fifth one, decide among several alternates. Another name of the structure, elif structure. In Java, else if structure. Next, sixth one, execute a block of statements when more than one condition is true. Another name of the structure, Akila. Another name of the structure,
nested if.
Good. See, in the last topic we discussed nested if versus compound condition also. Compound condition also. Just one more example, general example for Python control flow statements, conditional statements. Next, we will start Python loop statements. Observe problem. Lata, problem means requirement. Solution means observe the development terminology, programming terminology. Problem means requirement. Solution means program. Answer. Okay.
Yes.
Problem. My problem is find biggest number among 4 numbers. Observe, Sandhya. Yesterday we focused only first number. What is that one? A. Finding whether the first number is bigger number or not among 4 numbers. This time, focus on all numbers. Find biggest number. Find a biggest number among 4 numbers. Find these big number, or these big number, or C's big number, or D's big number. Yesterday we did only focusing on A is big number or A is not big number. But this is this time focusing all numbers. Getting my requirement, Lata? Getting my requirement? I think actually
yes,
you are absent now.
Yes, sir. I understand, sir.
What about you? My sound jaded. Is it okay?
It's okay, sir.
Okay. If you have any problem, inform me. Now observe. Sandhya, tell me, Sandhya. Did you observe my requirement? Find
yes,
the biggest number among 4 numbers. Among 4 numbers. Here hint, use compound condition and else if structure. Observe, A equals to 100, B equals to 90, C equals to 80, D equals to 70. Next, first focus on A. Use compound conditions and else structure. If A greater than B, A greater than B, and A greater than B, and A greater than D, colon, print if this compound condition is true, if this compound condition is true, print A is big number. A is big number. Next, using LF, focus on B, C, and D variables. See, LF, another second condition, compound condition. LF, Sanjay, focus on B this time.
Yes, sir.
Suppose B greater than A. Next, B greater than C. Next, B greater than D. Then declare B is big number. Next, Akila, focus on C.
Yes, sir.
Suppose C greater than A, C greater than B. Next, C greater than D. Then declare C is big number. C is big number. Next. First focus on D. D. D greater than A. D greater than B. D greater than C. Then declare D is big number. D is big number. Just run this program. Run module. A is big number. Yes, in this scenario, A is big number. Next, B 900, 990. This time, B is big number. Run module. B is big number. Next. Suppose A 100, B 90, C 800. Run. Save first. Save. Run. C is big number. Next. A 100, B 90, C 80, D 700. This time, what is the output, Jadet?
Yes, sir.
You are thinking it is very simple. Can you tell me, Lata?
D is big number, sir.
Pardon?
D is big number.
Good.
Oh, yeah, D
is big number.
700, yeah.
Next, observe Akila. What is the output in this scenario? What is the output?
C is big number, sir.
Pardon?
C is big number.
No, nothing is output. C is not big number. After third compound condition, C greater than D, it is false now. Not greater than.
Yes, yes, sir.
Run module. After nothing is output. Why?
Because it stopped the execution there.
Second one false. Third one false. One also false. No else part. Bypassing the condition. It is bypassing the condition. Suppose here write else part, else print. Suppose two are
same number.
More numbers. Two or more numbers are same. The background noise. There is Sandhya. Now it will execute else part. Run module. Two or more numbers are same. Suppose this time C is big number. It can execute. Run module. C is big number. Now Sandhya, try to break the program. Find out the leakages. Any leakages are there?
Sandhya. Two or more numbers are same, sir.
Okay. Try to find the leakages of this program. I think no leakages. Observe, this time it is A is big number. Run module, A is big number. Next, A 100, B 100. This time, else part, two or more numbers are same. Two or more numbers are same. Next, suppose this time B is big number. Save, run module, B is big number. Next, this time C is big number. Run module. C is big number. Next, suppose this time D is big number. Okay. Run module. D is big number. Observe Lata, any leakages?
No, sir.
Okay, it is working fine. Observe Akila. Next, sir. Akila, I declared four variables in four different statements. You declare all four variables in a single statement. Single statement. Declare multiple variables in a single statement.
A equal to 100 colon.
Just a minute, A comma, that is combining, if you use colon, combining, I am not combining, just a single statement, single physical line, that is single logical line only, D comma, D equals to, suppose 100, comma 90, 80, 70.
Comma after B.
Why?
It is missing, sir.
B, yes. Good observation. Say, run module. A is big number. Okay, na? You can use this one also, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Or this one. Okay. Next, come to mainstream. Jared, come to mainstream. Python control flow loop statements. A loop statement allows us to execute a statement or group of statements multiple times. Python programming language provides two loop structures, for loop and while loop. Suppose in Java, we have four loop structures added. What are the four loop structures in Java? You know Java, I think. What are the four loop structures in Java?
Yes, sir. It's while loop.
While loop.
Loop.
Do
while.
And
enhanced for.
Enhanced for loop. Good. See, in Java programming, we have four loop structures. One is for loop, next while loop, next do while loop, last one, enhanced for loop. But here we have two loops. One is for loop, another is while loop. A loop statement allows us to execute a statement or group of statements multiple times. Repetitive execution. Okay. First, I am taking for loop, Sandhya, for loop. For understanding these loops, syntax and example I will provide. For loop iterates over the items of any sequence, such as a list or string. Observe the syntax. For two syntaxes I will introduce. First syntax for iterative variable. Iterative variable in sequence colon statements. That's it. You don't focus on lists, data structures, Jadid. Don't focus. I am creating one list. Suppose it is a data structure. My list equals to square brackets 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40 comma 50 comma 60. Close square brackets. It is a Python data structure list. Other data structures are set, tuple, dictionary, that we will discuss later. Collections. Python collections are data structures. Chapter takes nearly 3 hours. Okay. For one variable, num or i, generally we use I, J, K like variable names in loop structures. That is not rule, standard. For I, in is keyword, Python keyword. My list is object, it is list object, print of i. Observe, Sandhya, tell me the output of this for loop. Already I told syntax, for loop iterates over the items of any sequence, such as list or string. What is the output? They are not responding. Why people are not responding? Any audio problem from my side?
No, sir. Hello? When we unmute, it's taking some time for me, sir. This is touchpad.
Okay, cool. No problem. Observe, Lata, what is the output?
20, 30, 40, 50,
60. Yes, it will display all elements of that list. Run module 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. 6 lines. Save. Observe 10 to 60 Jadid. Is it okay, Jadid?
Yes, sir.
It is list where list object. List object or tuple object, any object you can use. Next, sequence of strings also. Strings also. I am using in example two, one string. String. Suppose my country equals to India. It is one string. Display string characters one by one. For I, in, editor. Just a minute. Just a minute. For in string, my country, it is variable name, colon, print I. Now tell me, Akila, what is the output of this loop structure? Akila, what is the output of this loop structure? It will print
India.
All characters of that string. What are the characters? Five characters available in that one. I, N, D, I, A. Save. Already saved. Run module. I, N, D, I, A. Okay, now Sandhya. One more thing, Jagged, in our computer environment, we have three types of characters. You can use all types of characters for creating your strings. See, India, alphabetic characters, 1, 2, 3, digit characters, numbers. Next, dollar sign, percentile sign, asterisk symbol, special characters. See, in computer environment, we have three types of characters. Alphabetic characters, uppercase and lowercase. Next, digit characters. Okay, now run the program. Observe all characters. Okay, now Sanjay, rise for it. Yeah, are you there? Sandhya not responding. What about you, Lata?
Yes, sir. I can hear you, sir, and I can see the screen as well. The three types of characters are alphabetic character, digit character, and special characters.
Okay, good. Any query?
Sir, I have a question.
Akila, who is sir. Asking?
Akila, sir.
Tell me, Akila.
Declaring my country
as
a string or text file,
sir. India. Low voice, like that. From is it from my side or your side? Sir, are you getting my voice properly?
Yes, sir.
Now okay. Yes. Tell me,
sir. India is a string or text, right, sir? My country equal to India. India, 1, 2, 3 special characters, whatever. You are declaring it as a string or text.
Yes, it is a string.
Yeah.
String means but text. Text.
Yeah, your output is when you are printing output, it is coming in the text line.
Characters one by one.
Yes, one by one. So
one by one. String means sequence of characters. It will if you use for loop, it will display characters one by one. Any problem?
No, sir. Only because of the for loop, it is printing next line by next line, yes. Right, sir? If you just put print I, it will just
Okay. I is one variable. You can use any variable. My country is string name. If you in my country, so it will display characters one by one.
Okay.
Getting. Yes. Not from integer type data. Suppose if you declare integer variable, x equals to 1, 2, 3, it won't display. Only strings and data structures like tuples, lists, sets, dictionaries. Getting the point?
Okay. Okay, sir.
This is about displaying string characters one by one. Next, one more example, Sandhya. Observe print example 3.
Yes, sir.
Print 1 to 5 numbers. 1 to 5 numbers using for loop. For this one, I will provide another syntax. Observe syntax for variables. In this time, I am using range function. Range here. val 1, val 2. Suppose 1 to 10, 1 to 5 like range, colon, next, statements, colon, comma, statements, code indentation. This is the structure. Akila. Now print 1 to 10 numbers. 1 to 5 numbers. 1 to 5 numbers. Just a minute. For suppose I in range is function of your color coding. For is keyword. In also keyword, range of just a minute. If you don't specify range, only number, it will take end number. Then what it will print? It will print 5 numbers. End number is. Just a minute. Print I. Observe Sandhya. It will print 5 numbers. 5 numbers. Starts from 0. Range starts from 0. If you don't specify start value, if you specify start value, it will consider your start value. If you don't specify your start value, it will start from 0 to 4, 5 numbers now.
Yes, sir.
So 5 is not included. Why? 0 to 4, 5 over. Run module, 0 to 4, 5 over. Next. Suppose my requirement is printing 1 to 5 numbers. Here default start range is, start value is 0. Here my start value 1. Next 5, second one is included. Second one is excluded. Excluded in the range. If you print this one, if you execute this one, what will happen? It will print 1 to 4 only, I think. 1 to 4 only. Start value included, end value excluded. Run module 1 to 4 only. So here, if you want to print 1 to 5, you write 6. Means in the structure, that is syntax rule, start value included in the range, end value excluded. Save, run module 1 to 5. Just a minute. Next, Akhila, you print 10 to 15 numbers. Print 10 to 15 numbers.
Print 10 to 15. Okay.
I want to print
10 comma 15.
10 is start value
16.
16 excluded. Then it will print 10 to 15 numbers. Run module 10 to 15 na.
Sir.
This is about range function, built-in function. What can I add it for loop? I provided three different examples on for loop, Jadid. Printing a data structure, list or set sequence. Next, printing a string sequence. Next, printing a range of numbers. Okay, yes, now? Printing a range of numbers.
Range of numbers.
Next, Sandhya, before moving to next, what is that one? Loop, while loop. Before moving to next while loop, one small example to you, Sandhya, guide me. I want to print 10 to 1 numbers, Sandhya. Getting my point? I want to print 1 to 10 numbers in reverse order. Means my output will be 10, 9, 8, 7, up to 1. Getting my point? Print 10 to 1 numbers. Otherwise, you can say print the first 10 numbers in reverse order. Guide me, Sandhya. Yeah, if you guide me or not,
yes, sir.
Respond. Tell me something. Don't be in silent mode. You continue. Lata. You tell me, don't be in silent mode, Sandhya. You can tell me, I don't know. Yes.
But I don't know, sir.
Don't know, yes. What about you, Lata? You also?
No, sir. I don't know, sir.
Okay.
We did it before, but I forgot.
Got it.
Yes, sir. For num.
Minus one.
Just a minute, Jadi.
Print 10 to 1 number, sir. Sir, for num in.
In.
Range. 10 to 1.
What number?
10, sir.
End number?
10, comma 1.
And the number 1 excluded now.
Oh, sir, zero, sir.
Zero.
Oh, then zero.
Next, increment or decrement minus 1. Earlier, I didn't use increment or decrement. That is default. Plus one is default. Otherwise, you can use 1 to 10 or G. What is that one? 1 to 11. Comma 1. 1 is default, but minus 1 is not default. Print
I.
Minus 1 up to 0. 0 excluded, so it will print up to 1. Run module 10 to 1. Is it okay, Sandhya?
Yeah.
Next, Akila, one more example for you. Next, we will move to next topic. One more example for you, Akila. Print every 10th number up to 100. Observe. Suppose, try to improve your logic. Print every 10th number, every 10th number up to 100. First, try to imagine the output. What is our output? Print every 10th number up to 100 means first 10th number 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. That is my output. For that, plan the program. Plan the program.
For?
That is just wait. Akila can respond. I in
range.
Just a minute. I in range. What is the start value?
10, sir.
10. End value?
0.
It's 100, sir.
100. Up to 100, na?
Yes, sir.
100 excluded, na?
Yes, sir. Okay. So how much you are incrementing? 5 or 10?
Just a minute. First, specify the end number. First number, 10. Okay. End number, 100. 100 included. So 100 excluded. So use
101.
Next, increment. Increment.
Plus 10.
Okay, na?
Okay.
Print I. In this structure, first number 10, last number 100, increment 10. Save the program, run module. Observe Sandhya, observe my output. Is it okay? Confirm Sandhya. Any problem from my side, my audio, Sandhya, you are not responding. Tell me, several times I told, if you know or don't know, tell me something. Suppose if you know, yes. Otherwise, I don't know the solution. Like, I will answer it. Otherwise, I will ask for another person. Don't be in silent mode in recorded session. Okay? Sandhya.
Sandhya just left, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think she has some problem with the connection, maybe.
Okay, cool. Continue, Akila.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Run module. Next, Jared. One more example for you before moving to next loop. Covered for loop with different examples. Try to improve your logic. This time, Lata, I am inserting loop conditions in loop structure. Getting the point? So far, we used conditional statements, if statements.
Yes, sir.
So far, we used condition statements separately, loop statements separately. We can insert conditions in loops and vice versa. Now, in this example, I am going to insert condition in loop, mixing condition statements and loop statements. Added print 1 to 10 numbers except odd and seventh number. First Jaded, identify your output first, then you can provide solution. Identify your output. What is my problem? Print 1 to 10 numbers except third and seventh number. Condition is there.
Output will be,
means my one, output will be 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 3 and 7. That is my output. Yes, means condition required. See, we need to use repetitive statement, loop statement, and condition also apply. For I in range, for I in range,
one to
what
11.
Is the start value?
One.
End value?
11.
Next, increment 1, you don't need to specify this one. Plus 1 is default. Next, write condition. Stop the fourth, what is that one? Third record and seventh record. What are the records? Third and seventh record. Here, compound condition.
If I not equal to three and seven.
Don't write seven directly. Colon. Next. Print.
I.
Save the program first. Then it will print 1, 2, 10 except third and seventh numbers. Run module. Observe Lata.
Yes,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Is it okay or any confusion?
No confusion, sir.
Okay, go.
Now a query, sir. So if I write the if condition, like if I is not equal to 3, comma 7, will it work?
Incorrect syntax.
Okay.
Syntax error. After the class, you try. That is syntax error. If you use I not equals to 3, comma I, that is syntax error. Syntax error. How can you write that one? 3, comma 7. That is syntax error. Save, run module. It is not considering that one. No syntax error, logical error. It is not considering now.
Yes, sir.
It is not considering that one. Just a minute, save, run module. This is called logical error. Getting?
Okay, sir, yeah.
Logical error. Next. Akila, we are moving to everyone. While loop. Hey, I think in Java, I explained to you all of my Selenium students, I explained it. For loop, while loop, purpose almost same, style different. Based on your convenience, you can use them. What is the similarity of for and while loop? They repeat a block of statements. When to choose for loop, when to choose while loop. If you know the record count, you can use for loop. That is flexible. Irrespective of the record count, you can use while loop. End of the file, like you can use while loop. See, for loop, while loop, purpose almost all same, style different. Based on your convenience, you can use them. Next, what is while loop? It repeatedly runs statements while condition is true. It repeatedly runs statements while condition is true. Once you meet false position, it will come out from the loop. Observe the syntax. Initialization. Here first initialization. Initialization is integer variable. Integer variable. Initialization. Next, while. While is the Python keyword. Condition. Condition. Colon. Code indentation. Next.
Statement. Increment.
Statements. Next, at the end of the end of the block, increment. Increment or
decrement.
Decrement. Who is telling?
Akila sir.
Okay, good. Increment or decrement. Example, Lata. Example. Lata, print.
Yes, sir.
Print 1 to 10 numbers. 1 to 10 numbers. Earlier we printed 1 to 10 numbers using for loop. This time print 1 to 10 numbers using while loop. For loop, yes, while loop, purpose almost same. Use while loop this time. First observe. Initialize. I equals to start value one. I equals y. To one. While your condition I
greater than or equal to 10.
Equals to 10. Then include it now.
Sir, less than or equal to 10.
Colon. Print of I. Then it will print 1 to 10 numbers. Increment or decrement required now?
Yes, sir.
I plus. Condition. Yes, sir. Plus.
Here, Python doesn't support I plus, I minus, like you want to
react. I plus 1.
Just a minute. I plus. Observe what will happen. Run module. Error na?
Yes, sir.
It doesn't support unary operators. In operators chapters also we didn't discuss this one. I equals to I plus one. Okay. Run, it will print 1 to 10 numbers. Run module 1 to 10 numbers. Okay na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next Jadi. My requirement is earlier we used na print where is that one? Print every 10th number up to 100. Print every 10th number up to 100.
Print, yes, every
10th number up to 100.
First initialize.
First I equals to
10.
And while.
While a is less than equal 100.
I is less than or equals to 100. Colon. Next.
Print.
Print of I. Print I. Just a minute. Print I. Next.
Equal.
Decrement. I equals to.
I plus 10.
Take on.
Module 10 to 100, every 10th record. Rise query, Akila, rise query.
Query, sir.
Next, Akila. Your turn. Print. One to five numbers, except third number. Condition. Print one to five numbers.
Okay, sir.
Except third number. First, identify the output. My output will be, our output will be 1, 2, 4, 5, no 3.
Yes, sir. Yes,
1,
sir.
2, 4, 5, no 3.
I equals to
1. Mm-hmm. That is the starting value. Don't think about that one. While
I less than equal to 5.
Word I less than or equals to 5. That is the condition. Next.
Okay. If
now insert condition. Insert if block.
If
except 3. Only
I not equal to
not I not equal to implementation
3. Double braces set.
In this if block, write print statement. Print I. Next, increment or decrement required now?
Yes, sir.
I equal to I plus one.
This I parallel to if statement, not print. Observe Akila. Don't
yes,
use
sir.
Here I equals to I plus one. Don't use parallel to if. Parallel to if means this statement belongs to while now.
Yes, sir.
This statement belongs to while. Now it will execute 1, 2, 5 except 3. Run module 1, 2, 5. 1, 2, 4, 5.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, na Lata.
Yes, sir.
This is about loop structures. Next, branching statements are there in this control flow. Jaded branching statements. Notes I will provide. Observe my explanation and examples. Python. Control flow, branching statements. Branching statements. These are not code blocks, independent statements. We use these branching statements in loop structures. First, we have three branching statements, Jared. We have three branching statements. What are they? First one is break.
Next, continue. And then the last
return. Third one is return. We use a return statement in functions. Break and continue statements in loops. Break means the break statement is used to break out of a loop. It is used inside for loop and while loop to alter the normal behavior. The break will end the loop. It is in and control flow to the statements immediately. See, break means permanent break. Continue means continue also break jaded. Continue means temporary break. Okay. Break means permanent break. Continue means temporary. Temporary. Yeah. Okay. Suppose I have one range. I have one range jaded. That range is printing 1 to 10 numbers. Using for loop or while loop. Print 1 to 10 numbers first using for loop, then using while loop.
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. First, print 1 to 10 numbers using
for loop.
In the same program, print 1 to 10 numbers. Sorry, while loop. Between these two, use one blank line. Differentiate the or increase the clarity of result. Okay. First using for loop. For I
no.
In range start value 1, end value 11 excluded, 11 excluded. Next, print
I.
Save the program, run module. What is the problem? Line 3. Run module 1 to 10. Next 1 to 10 using while loop jaded. I equals to 1. Next while
I is less than equals to 10.
Colon.
Print. Print I.
I.
Then I equals to.
I equals to I plus.
I plus 1.
This is increment. Same. Observe middle. Print open and close. Double quotes, blank line, 1 to 10, blank line, again 1 to 10, run module, observe, 1 to 10, blank line, again 1 to 10. Now I am going to break the range. Say print 1 to 10 numbers. Now print 1 to 4 numbers. 1 to 4 numbers in a range. Forget about end value jaded. Suppose you are reading end value today 100 records, tomorrow maybe 200 records. You are reading the records from external file, but you want to execute up to fourth record. Here observe up to fourth record. If I equals to
4,
5, I equals to 5, break means it will execute up to fourth record only, na?
Yes. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Break. See, break from fifth record means it will execute only 4 records. Observe first loop structure, run module 1 to 4. I think run module. Observe Akila, 1 to 4 only, na?
Yes, sir.
Next, break the second structure also. Oh, just a minute. This one also, print 1 to 10 numbers in a range. Print 1 to 10 numbers in a range. After while if I equals just a minute, I double equals to is comparison operator, single equals to assignment, 5 colon, it is also block, colon, just a minute, print this one, not print this one, break, next, print statement, parallel to if, the second structure, run module, we have range 10, but I want to print up to fourth record. Run module. Observe Akila, is it okay? Komalata, is it okay? Rise query. Lata not responding. Jared.
Yes, sir. I got it.
Continue statement, Jared. Already I told, break means permanent break. Continue means
temporary break.
Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
Temporary break statement. Here print 1 to 10 numbers. You can use for loop or while loop. You try after the class while loop. Just a minute. Print 1 to 10 numbers. Suppose except print 1 to 5 numbers. Except four. My output will be 1, 2, 3, 5. For that, write that one. Except four now. Four or five? Four only.
Yes, sir. Four. Continue.
Continue means temp break, temporary break. Run module. Why it is not considering? For if okay, continue okay. Continue print. One to six means up to five records except four. Run module. Now observe Akila, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
1, 2, 3, 5 now.
Yes, sir.
Only fourth record break. Suppose permanent break means use break statement. Use break statement. Next, return statement is there. Return statement. So don't focus on this return statement. Guided. In functions chapter, we will discuss again. Return statement. We use return statement in functions. We use break and continue statements in loop structures, either for loop or while loop. Not either for loop and while loop. Getting this point, Akila?
Yes, sir.
We use break and continue statements in loop structures, for loop and while loop. We use return statement in functions. I'm creating one function. Don't focus. In functions chapter, once again I will explain it. Def, using def keyword, we create function. Suppose my function name is add. Add, suppose num1, comma num2. These are parameters. Parameters. Colon, suppose return num1 plus num2. Now, what is the output of this function? Based on the num1, num2 values. This function for adding two numbers. What are the two numbers? You can give the two numbers while calling the method. You can use dynamic values. Suppose first time 100, 200. Suppose next you want 1000 and 7000 addition. You can see if you use parameters, advantage of parameters is if you use parameters, you can provide the values dynamically while calling the method. Call this method. It is returning value now. Returning value. For storing that value, one variable required. X equals to adding two numbers. What are the two numbers? Any two numbers. 1, 2, 3, comma, 4, 5, 6. I want to add these two numbers as part of my program. Print of X. Just a minute. Print X. Now observe. Added, it will add two numbers now.
Yes, sir.
Run module. 579 is the output. Here we are using return statement. This is about Python control flow statements. Yesterday we discussed conditional statements. Today we discussed loop statements and branching statements, and I am going to close the today's session. Tomorrow we will start next chapter, strings. Any queries regarding this today's class? First, Lata.
No queries, sir. I'm clear, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Next, Jardin.
I'm fine, sir. I got it all. Thank you.
Next, Akila.
No queries, sir. Thank you.
Okay. We'll meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.